ο Θεός ημών πάντοτε νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Christ is risen from the dead, by death trampling down upon death, and to those in the tombs bestowing life.
Christos anesti ek nekron thanaton thanaton pati. Χριστός ανέστη εκ νεκρών, θανάτων, θανάτων πατήσας και της εν της μνήμασι ζωή χαρισάμενον.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. All holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, be gracious unto our sins. Master, pardon our iniquities. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
Thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, into the ages of ages.
Amen. Save, O Lord, thy people, and bless thine inheritance. Grant thou unto the faithful victory over adversaries, and by the power of thy cross do thou preserve thy commonwealth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Thou who wast raised up on the cross of thine own will, O Christ our God, do thou bestow thy compassions upon this, thy new commonwealth named after thee. Gladden with thy sovereign might our most orthodox hierarchs, and vouchsafe them victory over every false teaching. And as thy help in war, may they possess the weapon of peace, the trophy invincible, both now and ever, into the ages of ages. Amen. O dread protection that cannot be put to shame, disdain not, O good one, our entreaties. O all him theodogos, make steadfast the commonwealth of the orthodox. Protect those whom thou hast enjoined to rule over us, and grant them victory from on high, for thou hast given birth to God, O only blessed one.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to thy great mercy, we pray thee, hear and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for pious and right believing Christians.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for Archbishop Nikita and all our brotherhood in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For a merciful and member-friending conduct thou, and unto thee do we send up glory to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
Glory to the holy, consubstantial, life-giving, and undivided Trinity, always, now, and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. O Lord, why are they multiplied that afflict me? Many rise up against me. Many say unto my soul, there is no salvation for him in his God. But thou, O Lord, art my helper, my glory, and the lifter up of my head. I cried unto the Lord with my voice, and he heard me out of his holy mountain. I laid me down and slept. I awoke, for the Lord will help me. I will not be afraid of 10,000s of people that set themselves against me round about. Arise, O Lord, save me, O my God, for thou hast smitten all who without cause are my enemies. The teeth of sinners hast thou broken. Salvation is of the Lord, and thy blessing is upon thy people. I laid me down and slept. I awoke, for the Lord will help me. O Lord, rebuke me not in thine anger, nor chasten me in thy wrath, for
for thine arrows are fastened in me, and thou hast laid thy head heavily upon me. There is no healing in my flesh in the face of thy wrath, and there is no peace in my bones in the face of my sins. For mine iniquities are risen higher than my head, as a heavy burden have they pressed heavily upon me. My bruises have become noisome and corrupt in the face of my folly. I have been wretched and utterly bowed down until the end. All the day long I went with downcast face, for my loins are filled with mockings, and there is no healing in my flesh. I am afflicted and humbled exceedingly. I have roared from the groaning of my heart. O Lord, before thee is all my desire, and my groaning is not hid from thee. My heart is troubled, my strength hath failed me, and in the light of mine eyes even this is not with me. My friends and my neighbours drew nigh over against me, and stood, and my nearest of kin stood afar off. And they that sought after my soul used violence, and they that sought evils for me spake vain things, and craftiness all the day long did they meditate. But as for me, like a deaf man I heard them not, and was as a speechless man that openeth not his mouth. And I became as a man that heareth not, and that hath in his mouth no reproofs. For in thee have I hoped, O Lord, thou wilt hearken unto me, O Lord my God. For I said, let never mine enemies rejoice over me. Yea, when my feet were shaken, those men spake boastful words against me. For I am ready for scourges, and my sorrow is continually before me. For I will declare mine iniquity, and I will take heed concerning my sin. But mine enemies live, and are made stronger than I, and they that hated me unjustly are multiplied. They that render me evil for good slandered me, because I pursued goodness. Forsake me not, O Lord my God, depart not from me. Be attentive unto my help, O Lord of my salvation. Forsake me not, O Lord my God, depart not from me. Be attentive unto my help, O Lord of my salvation. O God, my God, unto thee I rise early at dawn. My soul hath thirsted for thee. How often hath my flesh longed after thee in a land barren and untrodden and unwatered. So in the sanctuary have I appeared before thee to see thy power and thy glory. For thy mercy is better than lives. My lips shall praise thee. So shall I bless thee in my life, and in thy name will I lift up my hands. As with marrow and fatness let my soul be filled, and with lips of rejoicing shall my mouth praise thee. If I remembered thee on my bed, at the dawn I meditated on thee. For thou art become my helper, in the shelter of thy wings will I rejoice. My soul hath cleaved after thee, my right hand hath been quick to help me. But as for these, in vain have they sought after my soul. They shall go into the nethermost parts of the earth. They shall be surrendered unto the edge of the sword. Portions for foxes shall they be. But the king shall be glad in God. Everyone shall be praised that sweareth by him. For the mouth of them is stopped that speak unjust things. At the dawn I meditated on thee, for thou art become my helper. In the shelter of thy wings will I rejoice. My soul hath cleaved after thee. Thy right hand hath been quick to help me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. O Lord, God of my salvation, by day have I cried, and by night before thee. Let my prayer come before thee. Bow down thine ear unto my supplication. For filled with evils is my soul, and my life unto Hades hath drawn nigh. I am counted with them that go down into the pit. I am become as a man without help, free among the dead. Like the bodies of the slain that sleep in the grave, whom thou rememberest no more, and they are cut off from thy hand. They laid me in the lowest pit, in darkness and in the shadow of death. Against me is thine anger made strong, and all thy billows hast thou brought upon me. Thou hast removed my friends afar from me. They have made me an abomination unto themselves. I have been delivered up, and have not come forth. Mine eyes are grown weak from poverty. I have cried unto thee, O Lord, the whole day long I have stretched out my hands unto thee. Nay, for the dead will thou work wonders, or shall physicians raise them up, that they may give thanks unto thee? Nay, shall any in the grave tell of thy mercy, and of thy truth in that destruction? Nay, shall thy wonders be known in that darkness, and thy righteousness in that land that is forgotten? But as for me, unto thee, O Lord, have I cried, and in the morning shall my prayer come before thee. Wherefore, O Lord, dost thou cast off my soul, and turnest thy face away from me? A poor man am I, and in troubles from my youth. Yea, having been exalted, I was humbled and brought to distress. Thy furies have passed upon me, and thy terrors have sorely troubled me. They came round about me like water, all the day long they compassed me about together. Thou hast removed afar from me friend and neighbour, and mine acquaintances, because of my misery. O Lord God of my salvation, by day have I cried, and by night before thee. Let my prayer come before thee, bow down thine ear unto my supplication. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all that he hath done for thee, who is gracious unto all thine iniquities, who healeth all thine infirmities, who redeemeth thy life from corruption, who crowneth thee with mercy and compassion, who filleth thy desire with good things. Thy youth shall be renewed as the eagles. The Lord performeth deeds of mercy, and executeth judgment for all them that are wronged. He hath made his ways known unto Moses, unto the sons of Israel, the things that he hath willed. Compassionate and merciful is the Lord, long-suffering and plenteous in mercy. Not unto the end will he be angered, neither unto eternity will he be wroth. Not according to our iniquities hath he dealt with us, neither according to our sins hath he rewarded us. For according to the height of heaven from the earth, the Lord hath made his mercy to prevail over them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our iniquities from us. Like as a father hath compassion upon his sons, so hath the Lord had compassion upon them that fear him. For he knoweth whereof we are made. He hath remembered that we are dust. As for man, his days are as the grass, as the flower of the field, so shall he blossom forth. For when the wind is passed over it, then it shall be gone, and no longer will it know the place thereof. But the mercy of the Lord is from eternity even unto eternity upon them that fear him. And his righteousness is upon sons of sons, upon them that keep his testament and remember his commandments to do them. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his throne, and his kingdom ruleth over all. Bless the Lord, all ye his angels, mighty in strength, that perform his word to hear the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, all ye his hosts, his ministers that do his will. Bless the Lord, all ye his works, in every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul, in every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, hear my prayer. Give ear unto my supplication in thy truth. Hearken unto me in thy righteousness, and enter not into judgment with thy servant, for in thy sight shall no man living be justified. For the enemy hath persecuted my soul. He hath humbled my life down to the earth. He hath sat me in darkness as those who have been long dead, and my spirit within me is become despondent. Within me my heart is troubled. I remember days of old. I meditated on all thy works. I pondered on the creations of thy hands. I stretched forth my hands unto thee. My soul thirsteth after thee like a waterless land. Quickly hear me, O Lord. My spirit hath fainted away. Turn not thy face away from me, lest I be like unto them that go down into the pit. Cause me to hear thy mercy in the morning, for in thee have I put my hope. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way wherein I should walk, for unto thee have I lifted up my soul. Rescue me from mine enemies, O Lord, unto thee have I fled for refuge. Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness. For thy name's sake, O Lord, shalt thou quicken me. In thy righteousness shalt thou bring my soul out of affliction, and in thy mercy shalt thou utterly destroy mine enemies, and thou shalt cut off all them that afflict my soul, for I am thy servant. Hearken unto me, O Lord, in thy righteousness, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. Hearken unto me, O Lord, in thy righteousness, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Our hope, O Lord, glory be to thee.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord. For our Archbishop Nikita, for the honored order of presbyters, for the diaconate in Christ, for the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord. For our Sovereign Lady Queen Elizabeth, the royal family, her government, and all in civil authority, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For the city, for every city, town, and village, and for the faithful who dwell in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For favorable weather and abundance of the fruits of the earth and temperate seasons, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For those who travel by land, air, or water, for the sick, the suffering, for those in captivity, and for their safety and salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and constraint, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Kyrie eleison.
Commemorating, O holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, Mother of God, and ever Virgin Mary, with all
the
saints.
O most holy Mother of God, save us.
Let us entrust ourselves and one another in the life of Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For to thee belong all glory, honor, and worship, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. God is the Lord and hath appeared unto us. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. O give thanks unto the Lord and call upon his holy name. God is the Lord and hath appeared unto us. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. All the nations compass me round about, and by thy name of the Lord I warded them off. God is the Lord and hath appeared unto us. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. God is the Lord and hath appeared unto us. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Whilst the tomb was sealed, our life did shine forth from the grave, O Christ God. And whilst the doors were shut, thou didst come unto thy disciples, O resurrection of all, renewing through them an upright spirit in us according to thy great mercy. Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίω Πνεύματι. Της Λιέρης των γόνων και του Όσλου το καύχημα, Χαλβαρδάν υμνήσομεν πόθο των μαρτύρων των συναθλών, Χριστών και των πλησίων γαρφύλων, Βολάστων τόξων είναι γέστερος, και στεφάνων ηξιώθη υπερήμων, πρεσβεύων των εκβόντων. Δόξα το δεδοκό της ίσχυν, δόξα το σε μεγαλύναντι, δόξα το ενεργούντι διά σου πασινιάματα. Και νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων αμήν. Εσφραγισμένου του μνήματος η ζωή ανέτηλας Χριστέ ο Θεός. Και των θυρών και κλεισμένων τις μαθητές, επέστηση πάντων Ανάστασης, πνεύμα ευθές δι' αυτόν εγγενίζων ημίν, κατά το μέγα σου έλεος.
Again and again in peace let us pray to the Lord.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Kyrie eleison.
Commemorating, O holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, Mother of God and ever Virgin Mary,
almost
all the saints
that
us entrust ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For thine is the might and thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. The soldier standing guard at thy tomb, O my Savior, became as dead on seeing the lightning like angel, who preached to the woman of thine arising, O holy Lord. Thee we glorify, who hast abolished corruption, Thee do we adore, who from the grave has arisen, and who alone art our God. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The faithful women came to the tomb before the dawning, and seeing the vision of angels, they stood in fear and trembling. Like lightning, the grave flashed forth with life. The marvel made the woman sore amazed. Thus they went to their disciples and preached to them the rising of Christ the Master. Christ Almighty plunder hate spoils, and raised with himself all corrupt in death, freeing them from fear of condemnation by the power of the cross. Both now and ever and unto the ages of ages, amen. While Gabriel was saying, rejoice to thee, O Virgin, at his voice the Master of all things took flesh. Within thy pure womb he dwelt in thee as his holy ark, as spake the righteous David in the Psalms. And in bearing thy Creator, thou wast shown forth more spacious than all the heavens. Glory to him that willed to dwell in thee. Glory to him that came forth from thee. Glory to him that through the bringing forth hath delivered us. O Lord, when the disciples concealed themselves in Zion, hidden in the fear of the Hebrews, thou camest in among them. O good one, although the doors were shut, thou stoodest in the midst bestowing joy, and didst show them in thy hands and thine all pure sight the wounds of the stripes and sufferings. To thine unbelieving disciple thou didst say, stretch forth my hand, stretch me out and see, I myself am he that suffered the passion on thine account. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O Lord, when the disciples concealed themselves in Zion, hidden in the fear of the Hebrews, thou camest in among them. O good one, although the doors were shut, thou stoodest in the midst bestowing joy, and didst show them in thy hands and thine all pure sight the wounds of thy stripes and sufferings. To thine unbelieving disciple thou didst say, stretch forth thy hand, stretch me out and see, I myself am he that suffered the passion on thine account.
Let us who have beheld the resurrection of Christ worship our holy Lord Jesus, who is alone without sin. We worship thy cross, O Christ, and we praise and glorify thy holy resurrection. For thou art our God, and we know none other beside thee, and we call upon thy name. Come, all ye faithful, let us worship Christ's holy resurrection. For behold, through the cross joy hath come to the whole world. Forever blessing the Lord, we praise his resurrection. He endured the cross for us, and by death destroyed death. Have mercy on me, O God, according to thy great mercy, and according to the multitude of thy compassions, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from mine iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know mine iniquity, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee only have I sinned, and done this evil before thee, that thou mightest be justified in thy words, and prevail when thou art judged. For behold, I was conceived in iniquities, and in sins did my mother bear me. For behold, thou hast loved truth, the hidden and secret things of thy wisdom hast thou made manifest unto me. Thou shalt sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be made clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be made whiter than snow. Thou shalt make me to hear joy and gladness, the bones that be humbled, they shall rejoice. Turn thy face away from my sins, and blot out all mine iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me.
Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and with thy governing spirit establish me. I shall teach transgressors thy ways, and the ungodly shall turn back unto thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, thou God of my salvation. My tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. For if thou hast desired sacrifice, I had given it. With whole burnt offerings thou shalt not be pleased. A sacrifice to God is a broken spirit. A broken and humbled heart God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, in thy good pleasure unto Zion, and let the walls of Jerusalem be builded. Then shalt thou be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with oblation and whole burnt offerings. Then shall they offer bullocks upon thine altar.
Ασομεν πάντες λαοί το εκ πικράς δουλείας Φαραώ τον Ισραήλ απαλλάξαντι και εν βυθό θαλάσσης ποδία βρόχος οδηγήσαντι οδήν επί νίκιον ότι δε δόξαστε. Δόξα τη Αγία Αναστάση σου Κύριε σήμερον εαρ ψυχών ότι Χριστός εκ τάφου ως περίλιος εκλάμψας τριήμερος των ζωφερών χειμώνα πύλασε τα σαμαρτία σημών αυτόν ανυμνήσομεν ότι δε δόξαστε. Δόξα τη Αγία Αναστάση σου Κύριε η βασιλής των ορών τη λαμπροφόρο ημέρα ημερώντε βασιλίδη φανότατα δορυφορούσα τέρπη των έγκριτων της εκκλησίας λαών απάστος ανυμνούσα τον Αναστάντα Χριστόν. Δόξα τη Αγία Αναστάση σου Κύριε πύλε θανάτου Χριστέ ουδέ του τάφου σφραγίδες ούτε κλήθρα των θυρών σοι αντέστησαν Αλεξάνας επέστης της φίλης σου ειρήνη δέσποτα δωρούμενος την πάντα νουν υπερέχουσα. Άγιε του Θεού πρέσβευε υπέρ ημών εν ουρανίστα λάμπης την εκός Χάλβαρδε φρενόμενος καθηκέτε δε Χριστόν δούνε μήτρης μάκαρ φωτισμών ανυμνήσε τους αγώνας σου τολμήσαντι. Άγιε του Θεού πρέσβευε υπέρ ημών εκγενητόρων προήλθες με νευσεβών και όλα αυτού άνακτος του Αγίου συγγενών Χριστόν δε φιλή σας εκπαιδός την του κόσμου ματαιότητα εμείς εισάς. Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίο Πνεύματι επί Θεών την ελπίδα σου τεθικό σε αυτόν αγνότητη κατεκόσμησας καλός και δικαιοσύνην εν κρυπτό εργαζόμενος εκείνο ευηρέστησας. Και νυν και αη και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων αμήν Θεοκα χαρίτωτε κόρη κρατέα των πίστων βοήθεια και ελπίστων ταπεινών σημε ελευθέρωσον σαρκός ειδονόντε και παθών των πολεμούντων με. Στερέωσον με Χριστέ επί την πέτρα των εντολών σου και φώτισον με φωτί του προσώπου σου που και στη γαράγιος πλην σου φιλάνθρωπε. Δόξα τη Αγία Αναστάση σου Κύριε και νους αντιπαλαιών αντιφθαρτών δε αφθάρτους δια σταυρού σου Χριστέ τελεώσας ημάς εν κενότη τη ζωής πολιτεύεστε αξίως προσέταξας. Δόξα τη Αγία Αναστάση σου Κύριε εν τάφο περικλειστής τη περιγράπτος αρχή σου απερίγραπτος Χριστέ ανέστης θυρών και κλεισμένων δε επέστης σου τις μαθητές παντοδύναμε. Δόξα τη Αγία Αναστάση σου Κύριε τους μόλοπα σου Χριστέ ους εκουσίως υπέστης υπέρ ημών τις μαθητές σου φυλάξας μαρτύριον εις εις έδειξας εν δόξου Αναστάσεως. Άγιε του Θεού πρέσβευε υπέρ ημών Εκβρέφους μεν τα ιερά, Χάλβαρ γράμματα είδας και οδόν εξελέξον του Θεού των εντολών και επί πέτραν των σόνικων της ψυχής σοφές στήριξας. Άγιε του Θεού πρέσβευε υπέρ ημών, ειδών γυναίκα εν γαστρή έχουσαν αθλοφόρε, επ' αυτίες πλαχνίστης και εκείνην βουληθείς, σώσε χειρών διοκτών, συν εκείνη τέθνικας πανόλβιε. Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίο Πνεύματι, εις η παράνομη φωνή σόνικων θέντες μήλων, το τραχύλο σου Χάλβαρδη θαλάσσης των βυθών, έριψαν σκήνος τον σών αλεκίνο, Κύριος διέσωσε. Και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων αμήν, Αγία Δέσποινα Αγνή υπέρ Άγιων Λόγων, σώματός ασαλόγω των αλόγων με παθών, υμνούντας ευσεβώς της λόγης, λύτρος επανάμωμε.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Kyrie eleison.
Commemorating our all-holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, Mother of God and ever-Virgin Mary.
With
all the saints in us, entrust ourselves and one another, and our whole life to Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For thou art our God, and to thee we send up glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Αμήν. Τόσον επίκες Χάλβαρδ πας είναι γνώστη, ο τρόπος δέος ως αλφυλάργυρο σώθη, αγάπης δε της μίζωνος, αληθώς οφθης έμπλεος, όθεν τέθνικας δικαιοσύνην φυλάτων και ηξίωσε. Μαρτυρικής ευκληρίας διώσε γεραίρομεν. Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίω Πνεύματι, και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Arising from the tomb and appearing past telling, amidst his wise apostles, the Lord said to Thomas, Thou seest my side, the wounds of the nails. Wherefore doubtest thou this my resurrection? Wherefore, being persuaded, Didymus cried out with faith unto the Creator, My God and my Lord are thou.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Kyrie eleison.
Commemorating our all-holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, Mother of God and ever-Virgin Mary, with all the saints in us, entrust ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For thou art the King of peace and the Savior of our souls, and to thee we send up glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. With his searching right hand, Thomas did probe thy life-bestowing side, O Christ God. For when thou didst enter, whilst the doors were shut, he cried out unto thee with the rest of the apostles, Thou art my Lord and my God.
Thou art my Lord and my God.
Who preserved the disciples' hand unconsumed when he drew nigh unto the fiery side of the Lord, who gave the daring strength to touch the bone ablaze with flame. Surely it was that which was touched, For if that sight had not furnished power unto that earthen right hand, how could it have touched those wounds which caused both things above and below to quake? This grace was given to Thomas, that he might touch and cry out to Christ, Thou art my Lord and my God.
Thou art my Lord and my God.
On the 15th of this month, we commemorate our righteous father, Pachomius the Great of Egypt. Pachomius, refining the flesh's grossness, reconciled it to the soul before it fattened. On the 15th, they took Pachomius hence. On this day, we commemorate our righteous father, Achilles, metropolitan of Larissa, one of the 318 God-bearing fathers who gathered at Nicaea. Larissa telleth of thy great deeds of wonder, remembering thee even when dead, O Father. On this day, we commemorate our righteous father, Barbarus, the myth streamer, the myrrh streamer. The myrrh that streameth forth from thy tomb, O Father, showeth thee not to be barbarous, but noble. On this day, we commemorate our righteous father, Andrew the hermit and wonder worker. Forsaking thy fatherland and bedfellow and children, thou dwellest in the desert like another Elias. On this day, we commemorate Saint Residius, Bishop of Wartham in Gaul. On this day, we commemorate our father among the saints, Esaias the wonder worker, Bishop of Rostov. On this day, we commemorate our righteous father, Esaias the wonder worker of the Kiev caves. On this day, we commemorate our righteous fathers, Ephrosinus of Sokov and his disciple, Serapion. On this day, we commemorate our righteous fathers, Silvan and Pachomius of Nerecta. On this day, we commemorate the Holy Crown Prince Demetrius of Moscow and all Russia, the wonder worker. On this day, we commemorate the holy new Hieromartyrs, Pachomius, Archbishop of Chernigov, and his brother, Abertius, a bishop of Zitomir, their father, the priest Nicholas, and their brother-in-law, the priest Vladimir. On the 15th of this month, we commemorate Saint Hallvard of Oslo. By their holy intercessions of God, have mercy on us. Amen.
Amen. Anastase os imera lambrin thomen laim, Pascha Kyrieu Pascha, εγάρθανα του προζωήν, και εγγύς προς ουρανόν Χριστός ο Θεός, ημάς διεβίβασεν επί νικίων άδοντας. Δεύτε πόμα ποιομεν καινών, ουκ εκ πέτρας αγώνου τερατουργούμενων, αλλά φθαρσίας πηγήν εκ τάφου ομβρίσαντος Χριστού ενός θερεούμεθα. Επί της θείας φυλακής ο Θεηγόρος Αβακούμ στήτω με θυμών και δεικνύτω φαεσφόρων άγγελων διαπρησίως λέγοντα σήμερον σωτηρία το κόσμο ότι ανέστη Χριστός ως παντοδύναμος. Ορθρίσομεν όρθρου βαθέως και αντιμύρου των ύμνων προσίσομεν το Δεσπότη και Χριστόν οψόμεθα δικαίωσιν εις ηλίον πάση ζωήν ανατέλλοντα. Κατήλθες εν της κατωτάτης της γης και συνέτριψας μοχλούς αιωνίους κατόχους πεπαιδημένων Χριστέ και τριήμερος ως εκεί τους Ιωνάς εξανέστης του τάφου. Ο παιδάς εκαμήν ουρισάμενος γενόμενος άνθρωπος πασχίος θνητός και δια πάθους το θνητόν αυθαρσίας εν διευπρέπειαν ο μόνος ευλογητός των πατέρων Θεός και υπερέν δόξος. Ενούμεν ευλογούμεν και προσκυνούμεν τον Κύριον, αυτή κλητή και Αγία ημέρα, ημία των Σαββάτων, η Βασιλής και Κυρία, εορτών εορτή και πανηγύρισες τη πανηγύρεων εν η ευλογούμεν Χριστόν εις τους αιώνα. Σε την φαΐνην λαμπάδα και μητέρα του Θεού την αρίζηλον δόξαν και ανωτέραν πάντων των ποιημάτων εν ύμνης μεγαλύνω. Δόξα τη Αγία Αναστάση σου Κύριε, σου την φαΐνην ημέραν και υπερλαμπρόν Χριστέ, την ολόφωτον χάριν εν η ωραίος χάλιν της μαθητές σου, επέστης μεγαλύνομεν. Σε την φαΐνην λαμπάδα και μητέρα του Θεού την αρίζηλον δόξαν και ανωτέραν πάντων των ποιημάτων εν ύμνης μεγαλύνομεν. Σου την φαΐνην ημέραν και υπερλαμπρόν Χριστέ, την ολόφωτον χάριν εν η ωραίος χάλι της μαθητές σου, επέστης μεγαλύνομεν. Δόξα Πατρί και Υιώ και Αγίω Πνεύματι, σε τον χωϊκή παλάμη ψηλαφόμενον πλευράν και μη φλέξαντα ταύτην πυρήτω της αείλου θείας ουσίας εν ύμνης μεγαλύνομεν. Και νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων αμήν, σε τον οστεόν εκτάφου αναστάντα Χριστόν, που βλεφάρις ειδώντες, αλλά καρδίας πόθο πεπιστευχότες εν ύμνης μεγαλύνομεν.
Save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Kyrie eleison.
Commemorating our all holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, Mother of God and ever Virgin Mary.
O most holy Mother of God, save us.
With all the saints, let us entrust ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To thee, O
for all the powers of heaven praise thee, and to thee we send up glory to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Ως πάντε Διε φύλαξας, δούλην εγγύων ούσαν, και των θυμών ουδέ δικάς, των αυτήν διωκόντων, τας εν γαστρινήν εχούσας, Χάλβαρδ παν σεπτερήσε, εκ πάσης περιστάσεως, αρρωστίας και βλάβης, τεσσές λιτές πιστητικών Ιησού προσπιπτούσας, και συνεκίνες απαντάς τους πίστος ετοιμώντας. εμών μελών χειρίσου, εξερευνήσαστας πνίγας, μη μυθωμά πιστήσεις, τραυματίσθεν τη διάσε. Συνμαθητές ομοφρόνοι και ζώντα Κύριε Θεόν, σήμερον εαρμυρίζει και κενικτήσεις χορεύει, σήμερον έρονται κλήθρα θύρων και της απιστίας. Θωμά του φίλου βόντος, ο Κύριος και Θεός μου. Πάσα πνοή ενέσα τον Κύριον, εν ήτε τον Κύριον εκ των ουρανών, εν ήτε πρέπει ύμνος το Θεό. Εν ήτε αυτόν πάντες οι άγγελοι αυτόν πάσε εδυνάμεις αυτούς η πρέπει ύμνος το Θεό. Του ποιήσεν αυτής χρήμα έγραπτον, δοξαύτη εστε πάση τη σωσής αυτού. Υμνούμεν σου Χριστέ το σωτήριον πάθος και δοξάζομεν σου την Ανάσταση. Εν είτε τον Θεόν εν της Αγίης αυτού, εν είτε αυτόν εν στερεώματι της δυνάμεως αυτού. Ο Σταυρών υπομείνας και τον θάνατον καταργήσας και Αναστάσε εκ των νεκρών. Ειρήνευσον ημών την ζωήν Κύριε, ως μόνος παντοδύναμος. Εν είτε αυτόν επί τες δυναστείες αυτού, εν είτε αυτόν κατά το πλήθος της μεγαλοσύνης αυτού. Ο τον άδειν σκυλέσας και τον άνθρωπον αναστήσας τη Ανάστασή σου
Christe, αξίως όν ημάς εν καθαρά καρδία, ημνήν και δοξάζεσαι. Εν είτε αυτόν εν ηχός άλπιγκος, εν είτε αυτόν εμψαλτηρίο και κιθάρα. Κοσμίος ο φροναντρίος και αφιλάργυρος, ειρηνικός και πράος, αναδέδειξε Χάλβαρθ, φιλών δε των πλησίων, ως σε αυτόν γυναικείε βοήθησας, διοκομένη και θάνατον συν αυτή, το ξεφθύσα δίκον έλαβες. Εν είτε αυτόν εν την πάνω και χορό, εν είτε αυτόν εν χορδές και οργάνω, ως Ιουδαίοι το πάλε Χριστού την έγερση, κρύψαστε πυρούντο ούτω άνδρες αιμάτων, φωνεύσαντε σε ρίψαν εν βυθό των σωτήμιων λείψανων, αλε φανέρωσεν τούτο λύτρο της, ως ειδούστε φως αμάραντον. Εν είτε αυτόν εν κυμβάλισε βύχης, εν είτε αυτόν εν κυμβάλισε λαλαγμού, πάσα πνοή εν εσάτω των Κύριων. Τυφλό ανάβλεψη δίδος Χάλβαρθ καλήνη και λαβών παρά Κυρίου η αμάτων την χάριν, διότις διανοίας και νυν ημών φωτιστήνε τα όματα Χριστόν της οποία πάστος τον ευλαβός ανυμνούντον σου την άθληση. Ότι ενίσχυσε τους μοχλούς των πυλών σου, ως θέλεις ψηλάφισον Χριστός το θωμά ευόησε, βάλε την χείρα και γνώθη με ως θέα έχοντα, και γεώδε σώμα και μη γίνου άπιστος, επίσης δε της άλλης πιστώθη τι οδεύοησεν, ο Θεός μου και ο Κύριος σοι υπάρχεις, δόξα τη εγέρση σου. Επένη Ιερουσαλήμ των Κύριων, Θωμάσο και δίδυμο σου κίνεν δημόνι νίκαση τις μαθητές οφθείς Κύριε, όθεν υπίστησε, της η Αναστάση και της κατηδούσισε, εγώ αημιβάλλω των δάχτυλων εις την πλευράν αυτού και των ύλων τα τυλώματα που πιστεύω ότι εξεγείγερται.
Και το απιστούντι
τους τύπους έδειξας. Δεύρο συλλάφισον τα σχήρας και τους πόδας και την ακύρα των μου πλευράν. Ο δε πιστής ευώσει ο Κύριος μου και ο Θεός. Glory be to thee who fashioned the light, glory in the highest to God, and on earth peace, goodwill among men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord, King, heavenly God, the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit. O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, who takest away the sin of the world, have mercy on us, thou who takest away the sin of the world. Receive, I pray, thou who sittest at the right hand of the Father, and have mercy on us. For thou alone art holy, thou alone art Lord, Jesus Christ, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Every day will I bless thee, and I will praise the name forever, and unto the ages of ages. Vouchsafe, O Lord, to keep us this day without sin. Blessed art thou, O Lord, the God of our fathers, and praised and glorified is thy name unto the ages. Amen. Let thy mercy, O Lord, be upon us, even as we have hoped in thee. Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me thy statutes. Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me thy statutes. Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me thy statutes. Lord, thou hast been our refuge from generation to generation. I said, O Lord, have mercy on me. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against thee. O Lord, to thee have I fled for refuge. Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. For in thee is the fountain of life, in thy light we shall see light. Continue thy mercy unto those who know thee. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy Almighty. Πνεύματι. Shine from the grave for Christ God, and whilst the doors were shut, thou didst come unto thy disciples, O resurrection of all, renewing through them an upright spirit in us according to thy great mercy.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Christ is risen from the dead, by death trampling down upon death, and to those in bestowing life.
Χριστός ανέστη εκ νεκρών, θανάτω θάνατον πατήσας, και της εν της μνήμασι ζωήν χαρισάμενος. Χριστός ανέστη εκ νεκρών, θανάτω θάνατον πατήσας, και της εν της μνήμασι ζωήν χαρισάμενο.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For the peace from on high and the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For this holy house and those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For Archbishop Nikita, for the honored order of presbyters, for the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For our Sovereign Lady, Queen Elizabeth, the royal family, her government, and all in civil authority, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For this city, for every city, town, and village, and for the faithful who dwell in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For favorable weather and abundance of the fruits of the earth in temperate seasons, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For those who travel by land, air, or water, for the sick, the suffering, for those in captivity, and for their safety and salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and constraint, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Kyrie eleison.
Commemorating our all holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, Mother of God and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us entrust ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For to thee belong all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Shout with jubilation unto the Lord of the earth, by the intercessions of the Theotokos, Savior, save us. Chant ye unto his name, give glory in praise of him. By the intercessions of the Theotokos, O Savior, save us. Say unto God, how awesome are thy works! In the multitude of thy power shall thine enemies be proved false upon thee. By the intercessions of the Theotokos, O Savior, save us. Let all the earth worship thee and chant unto thee. Let them chant unto thy name, O Most High. By the intercessions of the Theotokos, O Savior, save us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. By the intercessions of the Theotokos, O Savior, save us.
Again and again in peace let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Kyrie eleison.
Commemorating our all-holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, Mother of God and ever-Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us entrust ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For thine is the might, and thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. God be gracious unto us, and bless us, and cause his face to shine upon us, and have mercy on us. O Son of God, who didst arise from the dead, Savior, save us who chant to thee, Alleluia. That we may know upon the earth thy way, among all the nations thy salvation. O Son of God, who didst arise from the dead, save us who chant to thee, Alleluia. Let the peoples give thee praise, O God, let all the peoples praise thee. O Son of God, who didst arise from the dead, save us who chant to thee, Alleluia. Let God bless us, and let all the ends of the earth fear him. O Son of God, who didst arise from the dead, save us who chant to thee, Alleluia. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Only begotten Son and Word of God, thou who art immortal, and is condescend for our salvation to become incarnate of the Holy Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, without change becoming man, who was crucified, O Christ our God, by death, trampling down upon death. Thou who art one of the Holy Trinity, glorified with the Father and with the Holy Spirit, save us.
Again and again in peace let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Kyrie eleison.
Commemorating our all-holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, Mother of God and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us entrust ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For thou, God, art good and lovest mankind, and to thee we give glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Let God arise, and let his enemies be scattered, and let them that hate him flee from before his face. Christ is risen from the dead, by death hath he trampled down. Shine forth from the grave for Christ God, and while the doors were shut, thou didst come unto thy disciples, O resurrection of all, renewing through them an upright spirit in all according to thy great mercy. Εις Λιέρης των γόνων και του Όσλου το καύχημα, Χάλβαρ θα νημνήσομεν πόθο των μαρτύρων των συναθλών, Χριστών και των πλησίων γαρφυλών, βολάστων τόξων είναι γέστερος και στεφάνων ηξιώθη υπέρ ημών, πρεσβεύων των εκπόντων. Δόξα το δε δοκό της ίσχυν, δόξα το σε μεγαλύναντι, δόξα το ενεργούν τη διά σου πασινιάματα. Ως των Αποστόλων πρωτόκλητος και του κορυφαίου αυτάδελφος, το δεσπότη των όλων Ανδρέα ηκέτευε, ειρήνη τη οικουμένη δωρήσαστε και τες ψυχές ημών το μέγα έλεος. With his searching right hand, Thomas did probe thy life-bestowing sight. O Christ God, for when thou didst enter, while the doors were shut, he cried out unto thee with the rest of the apostles, Thou art my Lord and my God.
Let us pray to the Lord. Thou God art holy, and to thee we give glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, immortal, have mercy on us, holy God. God, holy, mighty, holy, immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Holy, have mercy on us.
Dynamis.
Ne dynamis. Dynamis. Great is our Lord, and great is his strength, and of his understanding there is no measure.
Let us attend.
Praise ye the Lord, for a psalm is a good thing. Let praise be sweet to our God.
Wisdom.
The reading is from the Acts of the Apostles.
Let us attend.
In those days, the apostles, having heard that, entered into the temple during the early morning and began teaching. But the high priest came and those with him, and they called together the Sanhedrin and all the council of elders and the sons of Israel, and sent off to the prison to have them brought. But after the officers came and found them not in the prison, they returned and reported, saying, indeed, we found the prison shut with all security, and the guards standing outside before the doors. But after we opened them, we found no one inside. Now when the priest and the captain of the temple guard and the chief priests heard these words, they were quite at a loss concerning them and what this would become. But a certain one came and reported to them, saying, behold, the man whom ye yourselves put in the prison are standing in the temple and teaching the people. Then the captain went with the officers and brought them without violence, and they were fearing the people, lest they should be stoned. And after they brought them, they stood them in the Sanhedrin, and the high priest questioned them, saying, we did charge you by a command not to teach on this name, did we not? And behold, ye have made Jerusalem full of your teaching, and intend to bring the blood of this man upon us. But Peter and the apostles answered and said, it is needful to obey God rather than men. The God of our fathers raised up Jesus, whom ye yourselves laid hands upon and hanged on a tree. This one did God exalt with his right hand to be a prince and savior, to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins. And we are his witnesses of these words, and also the Holy Spirit, whom God gave to those who obey him. Now after they heard that, their hearts were sawn asunder. And they were taking counsel to kill him.
Peace be to thee, the reader.
Rejoice in the Lord, let us shout aloud with joy to God our Savior. Alleluia. Alleluia. A great God and a great King over all the earth.
Alleluia. 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 Wisdom, stand aright. Let us listen to the Holy Gospel. Peace be with you.
And to thy spirit.
The reading is from the Holy Gospel according to John. Let us attend.
Glory be to thee, O Lord. Glory be to thee.
At that time, the people, having seen what signs Jesus did, began to say, "This is truly the prophet who cometh into the world." Then Jesus, having known that they were about to come and seize him in order that they might make him king, withdrew again to the mountain himself alone. And when it became evening, his disciples went down to the sea, and having embarked into the ship, they were going across the sea to Capernaum. And already it had become dark, and Jesus had not come to them. And the sea was stirred up by a great wind blowing. Then after they had rowed about 25 or 30 stadia, they see Jesus walking on the sea and drawing near to the ship, and they became afraid. But he said to them, "I am, cease being afraid." Then they were willing to receive him into the ship, and straightway the ship came to be at the land to which they were going. On the morrow the crowd which stood on the other side of the sea saw that there was no other boat there except the one into which his disciple entered, and that Jesus did not enter together with his disciples into the little boat, but that his disciples went away alone. But there came little boats from Tiberias near the place where they ate the bread after the Lord gave thanks. When the crowd therefore saw that Jesus was not there, nor his disciples, they themselves also embarked into the ships and came to Capernaum seeking Jesus. And after they found him on the other side of the sea, they said to him, "Rabbi, when didst thou arrive here?" Jesus answered and said, "Verily, verily, I say to you, ye seek me not because ye saw signs, but because ye ate of the loaves and were filled. Cease working for the meat which perisheth, but for the food which abideth to everlasting life, which the Son of Man shall give to you. For this one did God the Father see."
Glory be to thee, O Lord. Glory be to thee.
That always being guarded by thy might, we may give glory to thee, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Free.
Angelic, oh.
Let us complete our prayer to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For the precious gifts here set forth, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For this holy house and those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and constraint, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Kyrie eleison.
That the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
An angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Pardon and forgiveness of our sins and offenses, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Those things that are good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
That we may live out the rest of our days in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
The Christian end to our life, painless, unashamed, and peaceful, and a good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
Grant this, O Lord.
Commemorating our all holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, Mother of God, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the
most
saints,
holy,
let us entrust ourselves to one another in our whole life to Christ our Lord. God the Almighty, who alone art holy, and accept the sacrifice of praise from those who call upon thee with all their heart. Accept also the supplication of our sinners, and bring us to thy holy altar, and enable us to offer thee gifts and spiritual sacrifices for our sins and those committed in ignorance by the people. Count us worthy to find grace in thy sight, that our sacrifice may be well pleasing to thee, and that the good spirit of thy grace may rest on us and on these gifts here set forth, and on all thy people. Through the compassion of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thine all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And to thy Spirit.
Let us love one another, that with one mind we may confess.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the Trinity, one in essence and inseparable.
The doors in wisdom, let us attend.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. And in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one essence with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit in the Virgin Mary and became man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate, suffered and was buried, and on the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of the Father, and he shall come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. In one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I await the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
Let us stand with awe, let us stand with fear. Let us attend to the holy oblation, that in peace we may offer.
A mercy of peace, a sacrifice of praise.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
and with thy Spirit.
Let us lift up our hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord.
It is right and fitting.
It is right and fitting to hymn thee, to bless thee, to praise thee, to give thee thanks, to worship thee in every place of thy dominion. For thou art God, ineffable, incomprehensible, invisible, inconceivable, ever existing, eternally the same, thou and thine only begotten Son and thy Holy Spirit. Thou didst bring us out of non-existence into being, and when we had fallen, thou didst raise us up again, and left nothing undone until thou hadst brought us up to heaven, and hadst granted us thy kingdom that is to come. For all these things we give thanks to thee and thine only begotten Son and thy Holy Spirit, for all the benefits that we have received, known and unknown, manifest and hidden. We thank thee also for this liturgy which thou hast been pleased to accept from our hands, though there stand around thee thousands of archangels, and tens of thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six-winged and many-eyed, soaring aloft upon their wings, singing, crying, shouting the triumphal hymn, and saying,
Holy, 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 Lord of Sabaoth, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
With these blessed powers, Master, lover of mankind, we also cry aloud and say, Holy art thou and all holy, thou and thine only begotten Son and thy Holy Spirit. Holy art thou and all holy, magnificent is thy glory. This is how thou didst love thy world, thou didst give thine only begotten Son, so that everyone who believeth in him might not perish but have eternal life. And when he had come and had fulfilled the whole dispensation for us, in the night in which he was given up, or rather didst give himself up for the life of the world, he took bread in his holy, most pure and unblemished hands, and when he had given thanks and had blessed, sanctified and broken it, gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you, for the forgiveness of sin.
Amen.
Likewise, after supper, he also took the cup, saying, Drink from this, all of you, this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin.
Amen.
Remembering therefore this our Savior's command and all that has been done for us, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection on the third day, the ascension into heaven, the sitting at the right hand, the second and glorious coming again, offering thee thine own from thine own in all things and for all things. Also we offer thee the spiritual worship without shedding of blood, and we ask, pray, and implore thee, send down thy Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts here set forth, and make this bread the precious body of thy Christ, and what is in this cup the precious blood of thy Christ, changing them by thy Holy Spirit, so that those who partake of them may obtain vigilance of soul, forgiveness of sins, communion of the Holy Spirit, fullness of the kingdom of heaven, freedom to speak in thy presence, no judgment, no condemnation.
And we pray unto thee.
Also we offer thee the spiritual worship for those who have gone to their rest in faith, forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and every righteous spirit made perfect in faith. Above all, for our all holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, Mother of God and ever Virgin Mary.
O thou brightly shining lantern and mother of our God.
are superior to
Bishop Nikita, and grant that he may serve thy holy churches in peace, safety, honor, health, and length of days, rightly discerning the word of thy truth.
Kyrie eleison.
And those whom each one has in mind, and each and all.
And each and all.
And grant that with one voice and one heart we may glorify and praise thine honor and majestic name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever into the ages of ages.
Amen.
And the mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ shall be with all of you.
And with thy spirit.
Having commemorated all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the precious gifts he has set forth and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord. That our God who loves mankind, having accepted them on his holy and immaterial altar above the heavens, as a savor of spiritual fragrance, may send down upon us in return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray. Having asked for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us entrust ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
To thee, Master, lover of mankind, we entrust our whole life and our hope, and we entreat, pray, and implore thee. Count us worthy to partake of thy heavenly and immortal mysteries at this sacred and spiritual table, with a pure conscience for the forgiveness of sins and pardon of offenses, for communion of the Holy Spirit, for inheritance of the kingdom of heaven, and for confidence before thee, not judgment nor condemnation. And count us worthy, Master, with confidence and without condemnation, to dare to call upon thee, the God of heaven, as Father, and to say,
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, into the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be to all. Let us bow our heads to the Lord.
To thee, O Lord.
We thank thee, King Invisible, who by thy boundless power created all things in the abundance of thy mercy, bringing them to being out of nothing. Look down from heaven, Master, on those who bow their heads to thee, for they are bowed not to flesh and blood, but to thee, the God before whom we stand in awe. Make smooth in our path for our good Master through what lies before us, according to the need of each. Sail with those who sail, journey with those who journey, and heal the sick, for thou art the physician of our souls and bodies. Through the grace and compassion and love towards mankind of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thine all-holy good and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, into the ages of ages.
Amen.
Give heed, Lord Jesus Christ, thou God, from thy holy dwelling place and from the glorious throne of thy kingdom. And come to sanctify us, thou who art enthroned on high with the Father, and invisibly present here with us. And with thy mighty hand grant communion in thy most pure body and precious blood to us, and through us to all the people. O God, cleanse me, a sinner. Holy things for the holy.
To the glory of God.
Ah! Αμήν, 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 ευλογημένος ο ερχόμενος εν ονόματι Κυρίου. Τον Θεό Ιερουσαλήμ των Κύριων, ένι των Θεών σουσιών. Αλληλούια. Christ is risen from the dead, by death hath he trampled down death, and on those in the grave hath he bestowed life.
Always now and forever. Stand upright, having received the divine, holy, pure, immortal, heavenly, life-giving, red mysteries of Christ. Let us give worthy thanks to the Lord.
Glory be to thee, O Lord. Glory be to thee.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Kyrie eleison.
Having asked that the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us entrust ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
We thank thee, Lord, lover of mankind, benefactor of our souls, that thou hast counted us worthy today of thy heavenly immortal mysteries. Make straight our way, establish us all in the fear of thee. Watch over our life and make firm our steps with the prayers and intercessions of the glorious Mother of God and of all thy saints. For thou art the sanctification, and to thee we send up glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace.
In the name of the Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrieleison, 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 Pater Aie, Eulogieson.
O Lord, thou dost bless those who bless thee and sanctify those who put their trust in thee. Save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Protect the fullness of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house. Glorify them in return by thy divine power, and do not forsake us who hope in thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to the priests, to our rulers, and to all thy people. for every good gift and every perfect gift, Spirit, now and forever into the ages of ages. Spirit, now and forever into the ages of ages.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forevermore.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
The blessing of the Lord and his mercy be upon you by his grace and love for mankind, always, now, and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O God, our hope. Glory to thee.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Υιό Πνεύματι και νυν και αίγι στους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Πάτερ Άγιε, ευλόγησον.
May he who has risen from the dead, Christ our true God, at the intercessions of his all pure and holy mother, the holy glories by the power of the precious and life-giving cross, at the protection of the bodiless powers of heaven, through the intercessions of the holy glorious prophet foreigner and Baptist John, the holy glorious and all-praised apostles, the holy glorious and victorious martyrs, our venerable and God-bearing fathers and mothers who have shone forth in the ascetic life, our father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose liturgy we have celebrated, the holy glorious and all-praised apostle Andrew the First Call, to whom this church is dedicated, the holy and righteous forebears of God, Joachim and Anna, and of Saint Hallvard of Oslo, whose memory we keep today, and all the saints. May he have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and loveth mankind.
O blesseth and sanctifieth us for many years, O Lord.
In the gospel today, a great crowd chased after Christ following the feeding of the 5,000 in the wilderness. And Christ says to them that you haven't sought a sign, but you have come here because you were filled. And very often this is our attitude when we come to the church, and this is the reason we seek help from God. Not because we seek him for his own sake, because we wish to thank him, to worship him in humility and in love, but because we seek something for ourselves. We think of religion as a transaction. I give my time to church, God helps me with something. I give my time to prayer, God will give me something. Whether it's money, whether it's success, whether it's a job, marriage, and other things. But we see religion as a transaction. But of course, God has no need of that transaction, because God is perfect. There's nothing that we can give him. The time we spend in church, we spend for our sake, not for his sake. We don't worship some pagan deity who's constantly on edge, constantly angry, and we have to do X, Y, and Z to appease him in order for him to have mercy on us. God's love is constant, and he has need of nothing. So everything we do, we do so that we can grow closer to him, so that we can learn to reciprocate the love that he has for us always, and so that we can accept the love that he has for us always. Everything we do in the context of Christian life has that goal. And although, of course, there's nothing wrong with seeking from God various forms of help, we shouldn't forget the one thing needful, which is to worship God for his own sake, to come to know him and to come to love him for his own sake. All the other things are secondary. And so, and we often have the same attitude to the saints of the church, the saints who perform many miracles and who have stories of divine assistance and help associated with them. Those saints are the ones that we run to and that we celebrate and that we venerate. But very often the saints who were simply examples of what a Christian should be, which is why the church presents us with the saints first and foremost, those saints are forgotten. And today's saint has a very simple story. He was a rich man, a royal, who sacrificed his life trying to save a slave girl. And slaves at that time were not even considered human. They had absolutely no value. And he, a royal, a man of great social status and dignity, gave his life and sacrificed his life trying to save this slave girl. And that's it. That's the whole story. He was killed trying to save the slave girl. But after his death, the killers tied a millstone around his neck for his body to sink and disappear into the sea. But he floated back up, the millstone still on his neck. And so God showed him in a miraculous fashion to have been a man of holiness. Perhaps not a life of holiness, but that moment of holiness was enough, because in that moment, he, according to Christ, there is no greater love than to lay down one's life for one's neighbor. And so at that moment, he became Christ-like, which is the goal of Christian life. And that moment is enough for the church to remember him for all eternity as one of her saints. And so we shouldn't forget, when we look to the saints, that is the most important thing. The goal of life is to become Christ-like. And the reason the church presents us with saints is because they were people who became and who struggled to become Christ-like. Or everything else is secondary. Every miracle, every wonder, every story you hear, all those things are additional. And of course we glorify God for those additional things, but they're secondary. The first and only thing that we should concentrate on in our life is union with God and learning to love God and to accept the love of God. Everything else, as Christ says, will follow. Seek first the kingdom of heaven and everything else will follow. Amen. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.
May the Holy Trinity protect you all. Amen. Have a good weekend.